เช่นลังอาจจะฮอกเกนมีผู้เช่นเรินอีติงเย่าเจ้าผู้เช่นแม่น
This shop serves one of the best Malaysian Hokkien Mee in our town. I like to call Malaysian Hokkien Mee a black fried noodle. Just look at how black it is. Other type of noodles that can compete in this category of black noodles is jajangmyeon, a Korean noodle, and a squid ink pasta, an Italian noodle.There are four attributes of a Malaysian Hokkien Mee which I like to share in this video. However, we will not follow all four. Instead, we will change one of the most important attributes of this dish. Stay tuned! Attribute is the black color. Black is a must. Not just ordinary black, but super black. Hokkien Mee gets its blackness from thick dark soya sauce. The second attribute of Malaysian Hokkien Mee is using fresh large yellow noodles. See how large it is, the same size as this chopstick. If you are unable to find any large noodles, then udon noodle makes a good substitute. The third attribute, believe it or not, is cabbage. It cannot be any other vegetables. I don't know why, but cabbage is part and parcel of authentic Malaysian Hokkien Mee. The fourth and most important attribute is pork lard and a sprinkle of fried pork fats. Obviously, the meat must be pork slice. Sometimes they add a little seafood, either prawns or fish cake, for the umami factor. However, in our Hokkien Mee cooking today, we will be following everything exactly except it is chicken and not pork. We are replacing all pork related with chicken fats and sliced chicken meat, which makes this Malaysian Hokkien Mee not authentic at all. The Hokkien Mee sauce goes like this. 1 tablespoon sesame oil, 1 tablespoon oyster sauce, 1 tablespoon thick dark soya sauce, and half a teaspoon of pepper. To make the chicken stock, pour 100 ml of water mixed with 1 teaspoon of chicken stock. We start by frying 100 grams of chicken skin with the fats on until it gets super crispy.
What? Chicken? Aiya! Get you ya hoa! Ah, calling poke to you!
Trust me, this noodle will be tastier. When the chicken skin has turned crispy brown, set it aside, leaving 2 tablespoons of chicken oil in the wok for the next frying process. Reheat the oil and start frying 100 grams of marinated chicken meat. We like to marinate our chicken meat before frying so it becomes more tasty. Scoop the cooked chicken slice out and put it aside. Next, we are going to fry our prawns and fish cake. Once again, after cook, put them aside. Add a bit more oil. It is time to fry our vegetables, starting with some garlic and shallots. If you are interested to watch the full 8 minutes of stir frying noodle process, click this link above. In our Malaysian Hokkien Mee recipe, which is not authentic anymore, we are adding carrots, shiitake mushrooms, and green chilies to the mix. Of course, the key ingredient cabbage will go in too. Add in some chicken stock to help soften the vegetables. Then throw in the fresh, large yellow noodles. Give it a few toss until everything is mixed thoroughly, then add in the Hokkien Mee sauce mixture. Add more thick soya sauce to bring out that signature black color. Put back the cooked meat to the wok and stir it all in. Now we pour in the rest of the chicken stock and let it simmer. Cook until the sauce reduces and thickens. There you go. Our Malaysian chicken Hokkien Mee, not authentic version, is ready to be eaten. Now don't forget to sprinkle the crispy chicken skin to the noodles before you serve. Like this video and leave a comment below what your favorite noodle is. Thanks for watching.